You gotta ask yourself a question. Do I feel lucky?
Well, do you, punk?
Not a man on the planet that can stand before us. This is evident.
Not stand here in front of us because we're the real ones. We're the guys.
That's right.
You just seen it live.
There's got to be God.
How you doing?
If that's how you want to interpret the world as we know it, as it is, which a lot of it is unknown, you want to insert a God in, you know, any little situation in your life. These are gaps in knowledge. And this is how cult leaders are able to get away with some of the things that they get away with, is because they find these gaps in knowledge, these mysteries, where the answer is, I don't know, and yet they're claiming to know something that can't be known.
What these cult members need to learn is how to separate an argument from the person making the argument. Every time Tazadaqyah gets exposed, and your cult gets exposed, you don't want to address the argument itself because it's gonna expose you even more. So what do? You attack the person making the argument. That's all you can do. He's digging into these old doctrines to get information, and he'll put his little twist on it. What's so impressive about that? And how can you prove that the doctrine came from God? How can you even prove that? You know what they say? Well, how else did he get this doctrine? Or how else did he get this knowledge? Which is an argument from ignorance. So there's a gap in knowledge. There's a gap in understanding. The answer is, I don't know. But he's inserting something when the answer should be, well, I don't know how he's getting all this information. So I'm going to leave it at that and I'm going to be neutral about it. And that's the correct position to take. That's the correct position to take. The correct stance is, I don't know. I don't know how he's getting these breakdowns. Cult members love to use the argument from ignorance. Well, you don't know. Where's the tribe of Dan? You don't know. But just because you have an answer doesn't mean it's the correct answer. And we're going to get into that. That's how Tazadaqyah gets your attention. That's the appeal. He supposedly reveals a mystery. And then in your head, you're like, well, I don't know where it came from. It must be from God. Because you don't know, that's the answer. You stay right there at, I don't know. You don't change the position to, well, it's God. You don't do that. People do that when they say, well, you don't know how the earth got here and you don't know how everything got here. Well, does that mean that you could just insert a God in there? No. So it's not a good argument to say, how else? And you don't stop doing that. Like, I can't believe y'all still doing that. Y'all haven't learned? Like, go do a little bit of research on what an argument from ignorance is, the fallacy, and see that you committed a fallacy and stop. You guys never learn. You keep on keeping on because you guys are in a closed, insular environment where you don't get any information from the outside. You just closed out, and that's called information control. All you do is just agree with your cult leader, and you saying it yourself, that you don't need evidence. So you're always going to side with your cult leader. So you've proven to be an unreliable witness or an unreliable person. Nobody can trust you because if it comes down to it, even if your leader's wrong, you're still going to side with him. You're still going to make excuses. This is the same thing that Republicans do for Donald Trump. Because they have to stand by their leader. Because they've already chosen a team. They've already put themselves in a group. And they're going to fight for that group. And that's what these cult members do. This is not anything new. You can research this. There's been many studies done on cults and religious cults, why people continue to believe in these things, and it's all psychological, and it's not something that they're gonna snap out of, you know, overnight. So the best thing to do is, if you know somebody that's in a cult, don't appease them. You know, don't make life easy for them and not talk about the cult. You shouldn't just be closed in one group where you just get all your information from one source. You know, you've given this man too much power. And you guys are not realizing that you're the power. You are the power. The people are the power. That's why whenever somebody gets put out, what does Tazadaqyah do? He turns all the people against that person. That's the power that he has. It's you guys. He has no power. So, and the money is coming from you guys. So, I mean, come on. We gotta get this through our thick skulls, people. Come on. Let's wake up. And St. Basil's over here in the video talking about you gotta examine first. But then in the same breath say, well, we don't need no evidence. We don't need no proof. We know our leaders are doing right. Well, if you haven't examined, how would you know? You don't know. You believe with a lot of conviction. That's what you have. You're conflating belief with knowledge. That's what you're doing. You think you know something, but you just believe it real passionately. And that's the emotional control that Tazadaqyah has over you. Information control, emotional control, time control, behavior control. And you guys don't even notice that you're being manipulated, and all the power is in your own hands. A lot of people in the ICGJC cult always say, regarding Tazadaqyah, calling him the comforter sent by God, they say, well, who else is teaching all of this? How would you know if anybody else is teaching greater than Tazadaqyah if you're not out there researching? You're not out there looking. Have you checked every person on earth? Every church? You haven't done that. You found a cozy place in this cult and you got comfortable. If you don't say to yourself, let me fight through this fear that Tazadaqyah has put on me and use God and the fear of God to manipulate me, let me put that to the side for a second and do my own research and put the power back in your own hands. You're in a closed environment where the information is being controlled and you think you know and you're ignorant. And this ignorance, now when you have ignorance, this is where Tazadaqyah has room to play with your ignorance, and he can insert anything he wants into your mind. And this is what he did with the tribe of Dan. It's a mystery. There's ignorance about what happened to the tribe of Dan, right? It's a mystery. You see the tribe of Dan in the Old Testament, then you don't hear about them in the New Testament when it talks about the 12 gates in Revelation. So what did Tazadaqyah do? He put it in your mind that the tribe of Dan became the tribe of Manasseh.
Alright, so what does it mean when the scripture says that Dan is a lion's whelp, he shall leap from Bashan? What that's specifically talking about is a scripture in the Bible, a story where the tribe of Dan attacks and takes over a town, which is close to Bashan. It was a town called Laish. If you read the book of Judges, chapter 18, you can see that the tribe of Dan took over this town and called it Dan. So they were not only in their land, which was south of the Jordan, they were also north of the Jordan, which is close to Bashan. So that's what it's talking about in Deuteronomy chapter 33, where it says that Dan shall leap from Bashan. Now, if we go to 1 Chronicles chapter 5, verse 23, which is the connection that Tazadaqyah makes with Deuteronomy chapter 33, because it mentions Bashan, which was just a great land that was north of the Jordan, that a lot of the tribes bordered Bashan. So the fact that it just mentions Bashan is irrelevant to the scripture where it says that Dan is a lion's whelp and he shall leap from Bashan. It has nothing to do with it. Just because it mentions Bashan, it's irrelevant to the passage in 1 Chronicles chapter 5 verse 23 where it says the children of the half tribe of Manasseh dwelt in the land. They increased from Bashan until Baal Hermon and Senir and unto Mount Hermon. How did they increase? How did the tribe of Manasseh increase? They increased not in population, in land, in territory. This is how they increased, and it's right there in the scripture. And the reason why it says the half tribe of Manasseh, they weren't just a half a tribe. They were a full tribe, but half of the tribe was on one side of the Jordan and the other half was on the other side of the Jordan River. So this is talking about the tribe of Manasseh increasing in land east of the Jordan River because they were too big of a tribe and they needed more land. So they increased in land. And it lists from Bashan unto Baal Hermon and Senir and unto Mount Hermon. It's telling you all the lands that they increased in. It's telling you right here in the scripture how they increased in territory. So it doesn't make sense, the connection that Tazadaqyah tries to make with the tribe of Dan and the tribe of Manasseh. Because if you go to 2 Ezra chapter 13, where it speaks about the 10 tribes and their migration after the conquest of Assyria, you can see that it mentions 10 tribes, which would include the tribe of Dan. And this is way after this passage in 1 Chronicles chapter 5 verse 23, where supposedly the tribe of Manasseh would have increased with the tribe of Dan. Then why is the tribe of Dan mentioned in 2 Ezra chapter 13? Why are they included in the 10 tribes, which is part of the ICGJC's breakdown of the 12 tribes?
So if the tribe of Dan merged with the tribe of Manasseh, then that right there is not consistent with your logic about the father carrying the seed or whatever. What happened to the male Danites and their seed? That doesn't make sense, and it's not consistent with what you teach, that the man carries the seed. So what happened to the seed of Dan? How can it just magically disappear or convert into the tribe of Manasseh? So what you guys are saying is not consistent with your own Bible, with your own beliefs. It's inconsistent. You guys are bumping heads left and right, and you don't even realize it. And your cult leader is going to keep inserting ideas and his beliefs or whatever he wants into your head.
I am the Holy Spirit. I am the comforter that God has sent.
Christ put a label, put a title on that spirit. He called it the Comforter. Now the question is why?